I started looking at networking completely different, and I gotta tell you, when I did this, that's when I got some of my biggest breaks, and the doors just started to open. Aloha gang, welcome back to the channel, your number one spot for mixing and production. Today I wanted to talk about a side of production that seems sort of unclear, seems sort of daunting, and that is landing gigs. Landing paid gigs, networking, and how I was looking at it completely wrong for so long. Now, I don't want you guys to make the same mistakes that I did, because once I changed my mindset, it all became so easy. So this is something that I'm interested in, and I figured some of you guys might be interested in this as well. If you're just mixing and producing as a hobby, that's fine, but some of you guys might actually be trying to turn this into a career. So this is who I'm talking to. I'm talking to you if you're trying to make money from your passion. This is all inspired from a job I recently landed producing beats and music and sound design for a mobile game, and I can't tell you guys how stoked I am because it keeps me living the dream, making money off of music, doing what I love. It's expanding my network and it's getting me more experience. Now, I don't like networking. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's because for the longest time I thought it just entailed sucking people off to get your foot in the door, and being an introvert at heart, the idea of trying to swoon the room or be the life of the party was completely terrifying for me. But I started looking at networking completely different, and I gotta tell you, when I did this, that's when I got some of my biggest breaks, and the doors just started to open. Let me give you a little context about how I landed this job, and I want you to watch every second of this video because I have four big tips that are going to help you network, because you never know who you're talking to. So this job actually came from the gym that I go to. I train Muay Thai, and as you're in class, you start striking up conversations with people. It turned out that a buddy that I was partnered with was a graphic designer that had worked on some pretty big games. He was the main artist for Farmville. He worked on Madden and a lot of other big games, so he had been in the video game world for a while. He was going on his own as a freelance artist and was going to start working on his own games, and he asked me, because he knew that I was a producer, if I had ever worked on video games. So I said no, and he said, well, would you want to? And we've all been here. Someone asks you if you can do something, and that little voice inside of you always pops in and says, there's no way you can do that. What are you thinking? You don't know how to do this. Maybe it was the fact that we had just hit pads and done an awesome workout, but I say, yeah, I can handle this. So I jumped in and I started working on a VR game for Oculus. You guys haven't seen that, it's awesome. It's those VR goggles. Facebook recently bought it. Super cool. So I composed and I did the sound effects for the whole game. And it was something that I'd never done before, but it was fun and I was willing to learn. So that game ended up winning Oculus Game of the Year, and we were given $2,000 each and flown up to Silicon Valley to speak at the Facebook headquarters. It was an awesome experience, and now my network was even bigger. And guess what? About a year later, someone hit me up from that team to work on a casino style mobile game. This was one of my highest paying jobs. I was doing the voiceover, I was doing the sound effects, all the sound design, I was doing the composition of each level. I was pulling in about 4 G's a month. Well, that game tanked in about 6 months, but you know what? My network grew even more. And guess what? You know it, I got hit up by someone from that game, and that is how I got the gig that I landed a couple days ago. And I'm super pumped. It's a Candy Crush style game. The team is awesome. I get to work from home. The pay is awesome. And it all came from when I accidentally networked at the gym that one day. So let's circle back to networking and getting a job as an introvert. This is how my thinking changed. Networking isn't about sucking up to people. It's literally just having a conversation, and naturally the conversation is going to steer to what you do. And this is your chance to connect and really shine. Here are four tips the next time you might be in a networking situation. If you guys like these sort of how to make money making music videos, hit the like button. Okay, so tip number one is to just be yourself. I know that is cliche AF, but it's true. Beating yourself up, not being an extrovert, and being the loud, boisterous mofo in the room is only gonna set you back. Although it's important to learn from these people who are really outgoing, expecting yourself to behave like one isn't worth it. If you feel comfortable in smaller groups, there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. The key is to understanding your strengths and play off of those. For example, as introverts, we may be able to create more long-lasting intimate relationships. Tip number two is to redefine your approach. Look for scenarios where you can meet with people one-on-one. If that's asking them to go for coffee or having them come by the studio, or in my case, it was just at the gym. It may take more time to meet people, but the relationships you do make will be that much deeper and more significant. Tip number three is to tell yourself the right things. I recently saw a video by Professor Adam Grant, and he's looking at public speaking. And basically he found that when people told themselves that they were excited about public speaking, their delivery was much better than when they told themselves they were nervous. This seems like an easy one, but it's true. By recontextualizing your emotions and your feelings, you can affect your performance. Tip number four is to take advantage of the winner effect. The winner effect basically states that every time you win, you get a jolt of testosterone. This jolt boosts your confidence and puts you in a better state of mind. It also puts you at an advantage. With each additional win, you get flooded with testosterone, which gives you confidence for any challenges ahead. Before you go into a large social situation, and that can be terrifying for all of us introverts, get a few wins under your belt. It doesn't matter if you're an introvert or an extrovert, you can build a community of lifelong friends, influencers, and mentors. So put yourself out there and test out these tips. Eventually, you're gonna find what works for you, and you're gonna have no problem meeting new people and striking up conversations. All right, you guys, if you found this video helpful, make sure you drop a like, make sure you subscribe so you never miss a thing. Also, hit me up on Instagram, let's link up and let's build our networks. Aloha.